Welcome all once again, and a reminder once again that on our parish website, you will, if you go to the special box on the homepage for this special time of this challenging year, you'll scroll down to the home celebration. The booklet there has the hymns, the readings, the prayers for our Mass today. Of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Well, welcome to our celebration for this 25th Sunday in the ordinary time of our church year, with its parable today of the abundance of God's grace and mercy. So let's begin asking God's help to be ministers of that abundant love. Lord Jesus, your love is generous, embracing all. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you love the sinner as well as the saint. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your grace bears fruit in our lives. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And we join in singing our praise of God.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbour, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he is still to be found. Call to him while he is still near. Let the wicked man abandon his way, the evil man his thoughts. Let him turn back to the Lord, who will take pity on him, to our God, who is rich in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, my ways not your ways. It is the Lord who speaks. Yes, the heavens are as high above earth as my ways are above your ways, my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord. Please join in praying the psalm together. I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. The Lord is great, highly to be praised. His greatness cannot be measured. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. The Lord is just in all his ways and loving in all his deeds. He is close to all who call him, who call on him from their hearts.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. If our life in Christ means anything to you, if love can persuade at all, or the spirit that we have in common, or any tenderness and sympathy, then be united in your convictions and united in your love, with a common purpose and a common mind. That is the one thing which would make me completely happy. There must be no competition among you, no conceit, but everybody is to be self-effacing. Always consider the other person to be better than yourself, so that nobody thinks of his own interests first, but everybody thinks of other people's interests instead. In your minds, you must be the same as Christ Jesus. His state was divine, yet he did not cling to his equality with God, but emptied himself to assume the condition of a slave and become as men are, and being as all men are, he was humbler yet, even to accepting death, death on a cross. But God raised him high and gave him the name which is above all other names, so that all beings in the heavens, on earth and in the underworld should bend the knee at the name of Jesus, and that every tongue should acclaim Jesus Christ as Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner going out at daybreak to hire workers for his vineyard. He made an agreement with the workers for 1 denarius a day and sent them to his vineyard. Going out at about the third hour, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace and said to them, 'You go to my vineyard too, and I will give you a fair wage.' So they went. At about the sixth hour, and again at about the ninth hour, he went out and did the same. Then at about the 11th hour, he went out and found more standing round. And he said to them, 'Why have you been standing here idle all day?' 'Because no one has hired us,' they answered. He said to them, 'You go into my vineyard too.' In the evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his bailiff, 'Call the workers and pay them their wages, starting with the last arrivals and ending with the first.' So those who were hired at about the 11th hour came forward and received 1 denarius each. When the first came, they expected to get more, but they too received 1 denarius each. They took it, but grumbled at the landowner. Those who came last, they said, 'Have done only 1 hour, and you have treated them the same as us, though we have done a heavy day's work in all the heat.' He answered one of them and said, 'My friend, I am not being unjust to you. Did we not agree on 1 denarius? Take your earnings and go. I choose to pay the last comer as much as I pay you. Have I no right to do what I like with my own? Why be envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first last." The Gospel of the Lord. In reflecting on today's gospel, an interesting question came to my mind. What is the unforgivable sin? Now, from the perspective of our faith, of course, there isn't one. But from the perspective of society at large, there are 100 different unforgivable sins. Because while everyone has their own failures, everyone also seems happy to overlook their own faults and to judge others by the one laws that they themselves see to be the most important. And it becomes the benchmark for judging who's a decent human being. There's a positive skirmish taking place to capture the moral high ground. We live in a world, as it were, of competitive morality. And people are all too quick to demonize those who fail to embrace what they see as the issue, the right cause to champion. As an example, an interesting case in point has been in the news over recent times and relates to J.K. Rowling. It's like a moral tennis match as we watch the ball of self-righteousness go backwards and forwards, this way and that. J.K. Rowling was, of course, once an unquestioned hero, the writer of Harry Potter. Now, to some, she is the incarnate of intolerance and narrow-mindedness. When she outed Dumbledore, she was lauded for her open and tolerant stance. But more lately, she's come under fire for being narrow and conservative. She's come under fire from those who hold a view of gender fluidity. She's demonized. And of course, as is the tactic in modern-day secular fundamentalism, there were calls for her new book to be boycotted because she didn't think the way she ought to think. Next onto the stage came many advocates of the cause of women, who then demonised the proponents of gender fluidity for setting back the cause of women's rights, for relativising what it actually means to be a woman. The problem in all this, of course, is that they are all very important issues. But they're also complex issues, and they're not served by a fundamentalism that demonises one's opponent. Navigating through all this is a difficult task which requires humble searching, respect, dialogue. But instead it's demonising that we see skirmishes, even battles, on the moral high ground. Today's gospel is the great parable of the generosity of the love of God, of its all-encompassing embrace, of its ability to welcome all. It's a parable of inclusion, and in describing God, its challenge is that it should also describe us. Issues of morality are, of course, important to us as disciples. They're about how we act well and rightly towards one another. But demonizing serves no one. Paradoxically, we live in a society where there are no moral absolutes, but where there are plenty of people who are absolutely committed to their one noble cause. Puritanism is alive and well, just in another form, in many forms. Our parable today is about inclusivity, tolerance, a breadth of acceptance, a God who can embrace the imperfect as well as the perfect. Its message is that there's room for diversity in the kingdom of heaven, in the heart of God. An ethic not based on ostracizing those who fall short, room for the last and the least. People love to divide the world into angels and demons. And for too long, disciples say, as people baptized into Jesus, our call is to have a heart as broad and as encompassing as the God we believe in, and a moral compass which doesn't point the way to hell for those with whom we disagree. Let's profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray now for a spirit of generous service which does not count the reward.
We pray for Francis our Pope and Anthony our Bishop, that by word and example they may inspire us to be selfless servants of our sisters and brothers for the sake of the good news. Lord, hear us. We pray for the children and their families who are celebrating their first communion over these September weekends. May these celebrations lead them to ever deeper love of God and neighbour. Lord, hear us. As our world continues to suffer from the pandemic, we pray for those who have fallen sick and for those who care for them. We pray for ourselves too, that we may find strength in God, show care for others, and do all that we can to preserve the public health of our communities. Lord, hear us. In this month devoted to our awareness of the safeguarding of our young people, we pray that our church communities may always be places of safety, love, and nurture for children. Lord, hear us. We pray for our fellow local Christian churches. This week we pray especially for Reverend Chris Geringe and the congregation at Roseville Uniting Church. Lord, hear us.
Loving God, we ask you to hear the prayers we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Receive with favour, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what we profess with devotion and faith may be ours through these heavenly mysteries. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, sharing in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring us to the fullness of love, together with Francis, our Pope, and Anthony, our Bishop, and all the clergy, and all your people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we too may be counted worthy to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. We pray together in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. For those of you at home who are perhaps still unable to come physically to Mass, we certainly pray for God's peace to be with you. For those who are with others, let's share now a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. As always, please don't forget to download the parish bulletin from the parish website with lots of news and reading for reflection. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks, everyone.